which we have right here, we have a special gear with rounded teeth on it. Kind of looks like a beveled spur gear in a lot of ways. And we call this particular type of gear set a hypoid gear set. Now, hypoid gear sets are part of differential assemblies. They've been around for a long time, and they're a very robust gear set. They're very strong. And when we look at the hypoid gear set over here, we have what they call a pinion gear and a crown gear. So it's got the shape of a crown. That's sometimes also called the ring gear. So pinion gear and crown gear. Now, just remember, it has a similar function. It turns power at 90 degrees. It always has, because it's got angled sweeping teeth like this, or curved teeth, it has the ability to contact more than one tooth at a time. So the meshing of this, of these two gears, usually allows about two gear teeth in contact at all times. That makes it have the ability to handle a lot of torque and horsepower and the demands that the engine is going to put on it through the transmission. Hypoid gear sets. Differentials. Okay. Well, we're looking at the hypoid gear set and the beveled spur gear set inside. We may as well talk a little bit about how they work. Now, differentials are really, really important in your car. If you didn't have a differential, when you went around corners, both wheels would skid. So a differential's purpose is to prevent wheel skid when you're going around corners, so you end up with better control of your vehicles while cornering. Also improves your tire life so they don't wear as quickly. Now, when you normally are driving your car and your engine is sending power from your transmission through the drive shaft of your car, it'll end up at the back or the front side of the differential to a component called the differential yoke. And there's a universal joint in there that allows the drive shaft to go at different angles. We're going to talk about drive shaft as we go on in the course a little bit, but for now, just understand that a drive shaft turns the front of the differential assembly. And as the differential rotates, the drive pinion gear is going to rotate the crown gear. As long as we're going straight, both axles will turn at exactly the same speed. When we decide to go around the corner, you can see here what happens if I slow down one axle, the gears inside, the spider gear and the side gears, which are called bevel spur gears, will basically, when one side slows down, the other one picks up to allow the other axle to turn at a quicker speed. So it's going to differentiate the axle speeds or the wheel speeds as we go around corners. We would go to the other side and we turn in the opposite direction, then we slow down that one gear on that side and we speed up the other wheel. And as that happens, we have what they call a differential effect. Now the parts of the differential, the axles, the crown gear once more, the pinion gear, the spider gear, which is the small ones, and the side gear are the primary pieces of differential. We also have what they call a differential case in the middle that basically carries the gears internally. And then there's some bearing caps over here with bearings inside to allow that differential assembly inside to rotate. And this is all housed in a big housing. So one other thing here, we have a shaft that connects the, what we call the yoke of the differential, the drive yoke, to a shaft called a pinion shaft, which drives the pinion gear. So yoke, pinion shaft, pinion gear, crown, axles, spider and side gears, and bearing caps. All right.